been a really long day and I just really want to get some sleep for tomorrow. But I don't know if that's even going to happen. I might just end up sitting somewhere awake. I don't know.
Just got the cardboard tonight. I packed a lot, so it should be a little bit comfortable. I'm so tired, it doesn't even matter. And then I got this big piece right here, and I'm going to cover that right over top. And hopefully no one will bother me for a little bit.
Oh, man.
How you feeling?
Not too bad.
Sunny, like you wanted.
Sunny is good. Sunny is very good. Oh, I woke up at 6.
Oh, did you?
And I was like, oh, just because I was so cold. Yes! One more day.
You know what's funny is, like, there's a model school in there. Like, the past week, I see all these, like, really attractive girls and everything, and they don't even, like, they just look at me, and they're like, ugh. Go by them, and I smell. Should come back later.
Hey, oh, yeah.
Here's a copy of my movie. Yeah. See you later. Oh, yeah, just what I thought. It just tastes like French's mustard. Mustard and fish?
Can I apply for the job? No. Why not? Are you looking for someone in particular? Is that why you don't think I'd be good to work here? There's only one thing that might be a problem. I'm homeless. Do you think that'd be a problem?
Oh, I just think
so. Okay, thank you.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting in the evening come. Watching the ships roll in, then I watch them roll away again. Yeah, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Ooh, yes. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home.
Hi. I was just wondering, I've been phoning the past 2 days and I was just in the area. I just wanted to see if there's any rooms available. Yeah. Probably not, right?
Yeah.
Oh. Got lucky.
Okay, great. Yeah. I've never been in one before, so I don't quite know how it works. So if I want to keep this bed, I'd have to stay here all day, right? Is that how it works? Or can I leave it and then I can go out and make some more money and come back, or?
Do that.
Great. So I'll see you then. Thank you very much.
Okay. I went and went to the shelter and I'm gonna stay there tonight. I really would like a shower. I feel terrible actually. So I did lie to the woman about why I'm on the street, how long and all this. But I wanna go and see what it's like in there. And so far, like, when I phoned, they weren't, like, I wasn't that great on the phone. Like, there's some, I didn't feel too comfortable with them and I didn't wanna go in. But once I went in, this one woman was just wonderful. Just amazing. It's like a mother. It was just like, it's great. But yeah, I'm gonna go out, try to make a couple more bucks and go into the shelter, and I'll tell you how it was the next day.
This is the end, beautiful friend. This is the end, my only friend, the end of our elaborate plans, the end.
I was really nervous because it would be the first time that I'd really be around a lot of people that were homeless and in the same kind of spot that I was or whatever. They put you through a kind of process where they fill out your name and everything, but then they start pushing right away for what are you planning to do? Like, what are you going to do? Are you going to get a job? Where are you going to get a job? What kind of stuff do you like? Are you on welfare? Can we get you on welfare? They're really concerned about me being a binner, going into the bins and collecting the bottles. Apparently they're worried my clothes would have bug eggs in them. Got into the shower and oh man, did it feel good. Hot water and everything. I was in the shower probably for about 15 minutes. I must have washed myself 3 times and washed my hair twice. The guy that I met in the bathroom that was smoking crack, I realized that he'd be the guy that would be sleeping above me. So that made me a little bit nervous. So I knew that there was kind of aggressive people in there and there were people on drugs and there were drugs in that place. It's gonna be nice to see my family for sure. I know that my mom's been worried the whole time and my stepdad and my sister. So it'd be nice to know that they're kind of relaxed after I get back, and it'd be nice to have a place that I can pretty much call my own, sit down on my couch, watch my TV.
Get to see my mom though. I can't believe today's the day.
Something happened here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there telling me I got to be
there. Those are puppies!
Time we stop, children, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down.
Come here. How you doing?
How are you doing?
Oh, I'm worn out. Come here.
No way, yo.
Who's that strange guy? Oh,
look at all these clothes.
What do you have here?
Oh my god. Look at all the clothes I have. That's crazy. Oh. Crazy. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this is amazing. Look at all the stuff I have.
Yes. Oh, it's good to be home.
This whole experience has shown me, like, societies, there's still good people out there that are willing to help you. No matter what, there's still good people out there. Makes me feel a lot better about people on this earth, because for a long time I gave money to homeless guys and smokes, and I'd talk to them and be pleasant. I wouldn't like shrug them off, but I don't know, now I see why people help other people. It's like, I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain, I guess. There's a lot of people out there that ignore that, and they just be like, you know what, like, I'm gonna live my life, and they look at someone like a homeless person and be like, ah, you're just in it for the drugs and whatever. But there could be a story like their family had a breakdown and now he had no choice but to live on the street. And I'm not going to judge these people anymore, that's for sure. It's just like, I know kind of what you're going through now, and yeah, they need help. And well, a lot of them don't want help. I think when you're on drugs, drugs is the biggest problem, I think, in the world now. It's drug. I'm done.